Welcome, this is Helaluddin Ahmed and today we will going to discuss on mergers and acquisitions. What is mergers and acquisitions? Mergers and acquisitions are defined as consolidation of companies. Differentiating the two terms, mergers is the combination of two companies to form one, while acquisition is one company taken over by the other. Merger and acquisition is one of the major aspects of corporate finance world. The reasoning behind merger and acquisition generally given is that two separate companies together create more value compared to being on an individual stand. With the objective of wealth maximization, companies keep evaluating different opportunities through the route of merger or acquisition. So why the companies are going for mergers or acquisitions? Sometimes the companies want to buy assets of the other companies. And also they can want to purchase the common shares of the other company. And sometimes maybe it can be possible by exchange of shares of assets and by exchanging shares of shares. There are different types of mergers and acquisitions. Merger or amalgamation may take two forms. Merger through absorption and merger through consolidation. Mergers can also be classified into three types from an economic perspective, depending on the business combination, whether in the same industry or not, into horizontal, where two firms are in the same industry, and there is vertical, at different production stages or value chain with other companies, and conglomerate, where the industries are not related to each other. From a legal perspective, there are different types of mergers like statutory merger, short form merger, subsidiary merger, and merger of equals. There are lots of reasons for a company go for mergers or acquisitions. At very first, we can say that there are financial synergy for lower cost of capital of a company, and this is one of the main reasons for merger. Another reason can be improving company's performance and accelerate growth. To increase the economic of scale is another reason for the merger within the companies, and also the diversification of higher growth products or markets. One of the other reasons to company go for mergers is to increase market shares and positioning given broader market access, and it can be also the improving company's performance and accelerate growth. And there are other reasons like tax consideration, under value target, and finally, diversification of risk. One thing you should remember, that the main principle behind any merger and acquisition is synergy. There is always synergy value created by the joining or merger of two companies. The synergy value can be seen either through the revenues, expenses, or the cost of capital. The three important considerations should be taken into account of going for a merger acquisition. Number one, the company must be willing to take the risk and resiliently make investment to benefit fully from the merger, as the competitors and the industry take hit quickly. And the next one is to reduce the diversified risk. Multiple bets must be made in order to narrow down to the one that will prove fruitful. And the final one, the management of acquiring the firm must learn to be resilient, patient, and be able to adapt to change owing to ever-changing business dynamics in the industry. There are some stages that involved in any merger and acquisition. Phase one, that is, include self-assessment of the acquiring company with regarding to the needs for merger and acquisition, ascertain the valuation, that chalk out the growth plan through the target. The next phase is searching for the possible threats to take over candidates. This process is mainly to scan for a good strategic fit for the acquiring company. Once the appropriate company is shortlisted, through the primary screening, detailed analyzing of the target company has to be done. This is also referred to as due diligence. At phase 4, when the company, target company is selected, the next step is to start negotiations to come to consensus for a negotiated merger or a bear hug. This brings both the companies to agree mutually to the deal for a long-term working of the merger and acquisition. Finally, if all above steps fall in place, there is a formal announcement of the agreement of merger by both the participating companies. But there are some reasons that leads any failure of merger or acquisition, which should be analyzed during the stages of merger and acquisition. The one reason is poor strategic fit, that is, wide difference in objectives and strategies of the company. Another reason, that is, poor managed integration, because integration is often poorly managed without planning and design. This leads to failure of implementation. If you discuss for other reasons like incomplete due diligence, inadequate due diligence can lead to failure of merger and acquisition, as it is the crux of the entire strategy. And the final reason can be too optimistic projection about the target company leads to bad decision and the failure of the merger and acquisition. And that's all for now. Thank you.